exercises, all question answers of previous lesson. Now we are going to start our new lesson, lesson number 6, that is physical and chemical changes. Okay, so be ready to write the name and the keyword in your notebook. Okay, so write the name of session number 1, that is students will be able to classify physical and chemical changes based on whether a new substance is formed or not. Understood the aim? Okay. See, students will be able to classify physical and chemical changes based on whether a new substance is formed or not. Then there are two keywords. First one, physical change, and second one is chemical change. Okay. Now take the screenshot of aim and keywords. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. I hope that you have taken the screenshot. Now in this session we are going to discuss 3 main points. First one, physical and chemical properties. Next one, overview of types of changes, and the main point, that is difference between physical and chemical changes. So this lesson, that is physical and chemical changes, this lesson is related to the matter. So can you tell me what is the matter? Matter means what? Anything that takes place, okay, or space. Means what? Your chalk, pen, notebook, brief, okay, all these are matter. Okay, and related to the matter we are going to learn physical properties and chemical properties. Now what is the difference between physical and chemical? Physical means what? Physical properties means we are going to learn the properties that we can easily touch or understand by our senses. For example, size, color, shape, texture, hardness, taste, temperature, state, mass and volume. Means what? Take example of chalk. Okay, you can tell the size, shape, state, mass, volume, okay, of this chalk easily. Okay, so that all properties are known as physical properties, means related to the appearance. Understood the physical properties? See how much physical properties I have given. Next, opposite to that, there are chemical properties. Now you are in 7th standard, correct? So I think you know about the molecule arrangement, means solid, liquid and gas. Okay, solid, liquid, gas. In solid, the molecules are arranged in compound. In liquid, the little bit different. And in gas, the molecules are everywhere. So in this molecule, means in between the two molecules, there is a bond or a particular force. So that are your chemical properties. Means related to the molecules, okay, the properties are there. Like your toxicity, means which chemical or which element or which substance is present in that particular matter. So toxicity. Next one, flammability. Okay, see, some substances are there like your perfumes and all. Okay, there is written flammable. Means what? That is your chemical property. Next one is reactivity. Okay, the reaction, the chemical reaction between two elements or two compounds. Next one, burning. Next, your corrosion. Next, rusting and the pH. Okay, already we have learned about the pH, that is acid, bases and salts. Okay, in that lesson we have learned about pH. So understood the physical properties and the chemical properties. Okay, see the physical and chemical properties and write down in your notebook. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Okay. So I hope that you have understand aim, keywords, and the physical and chemical properties. Now, based on these properties, we are going to learn the types of changes and the difference between physical and chemical changes. Okay. So let's start the overview of types of changes. Before we will start the types of changes, okay, the overview of types of changes, first tell me what are the changes. Have you observed some changes around you? Have you observed that? The ripening of fruits, the falling down of leaves, your hair are growing. So these all are changes, okay, but there are different types of changes. Means what? See, the ripening of fruit, that is a natural change, and we can say that for ripening process that fruit is taking more time, means that change is also slow change. So according to that means time, okay, the particular classification is there of changes. Okay, so see, I have written four types of changes, okay, four groups. First, natural and man-made, slow and fast, periodic and non-periodic, and reversible and irreversible. So these two changes are important, okay, that we are going to learn in physical and chemical changes. So natural and man-made changes, the first group. Natural means what? The change is happening naturally, okay, the falling of leaves. We are not going, okay, and just taking the leaves and just put down. Naturally, the leaves are falling down. Naturally, there is a ripening of fruit. Okay, so that changes, okay, that happens naturally are known as natural changes. Opposite to that, man-made changes are also there. Now, man-made means what? The chair. Take the example of chair. Are the chairs getting from the nature directly? No. First we have to cut that wood and then we have to make the chair from that wood. So that change is known as man-made change. Understood this group? Next is slow and fast. Slow means what? For that change, okay, more time is required for that change. Means that change is slow change. Opposite to that, if the change takes place in a short period, so that is your fast change. Slow change, you can say the ripening of fruit. Fast change, you can say your earthquake, volcanoes. Okay. Next is periodic and non-periodic. Periodic means what? The time is perfect. For example, your rotation of the earth, your revolution of the earth, correct? Rotation of the earth takes place in a one day, that is 24 hours, correct? If the earth is feeling that weak and all, so that earth is taking more period, more time to rotate? No. Earth is taking 24 hours to complete one rotation. So that is your periodic change. And non-periodic is what? The change is there, but not in a perfect time. Understood? And the last and the important change, that is reversible and irreversible change. Now reversible means what? For example, ice can be converted into water by heating. That water can be converted into ice by cooling. Means we can take that things reverse. So that change is known as reversible change. And opposite to that, irreversible. Means change is there, but that thing we cannot get back. For example, you are cracking of egg. Okay, if you want to make omelette, you have to crack that egg. But from that omelette, can you make egg? No. So that is our irreversible change. Okay, you have to learn these two two changes. Okay, these I have given only for your extra information. Means you should know what kind of changes are there. Okay, the reversible and irreversible changes are the main changes, and according to that, now we will learn the difference between physical and chemical changes. Okay. But before that, we will do three activities, okay? And from that activities, we will discuss about physical changes only. In this session, we are going to learn in detail about physical changes, not the chemical changes, okay? That part is different. Understood? So let's start our activity. Okay. In your textbook, there is mentioned activity 6.1. 6.2, 6.3 and 6.4. But now we will do only two activities, that is 6.1 and 6.2. So in first activity, see, you have to cut a piece of paper in four pieces, okay? Randomly cut the paper in four pieces. See. Now tell me, is this change? See, first I have like this paper. Now I tore that paper in four pieces. Means there is a change. Correct? Now the second activity, that is 6.2. See, I have taken the piece of chalks. Now I will make a powder of that chalk to get the chalk dust. Now tell me, is it change? Yes, it is also a change, as I have changed the chalk into chalk dust. And the new activity, that is not mentioned in your textbook, about rubber band. See, I have taken rubber. Now I am stretching that rubber. Correct? This is also a change? Yes. But what happened when I just remove the force? That rubber is in original shape, is in original position. Correct? So what you have understand from these three activities? Can you tell me? Now we are learning about changes. Okay? I tore the paper. I make the chalk dust. Then I stretch the rubber. Now what happened here? Can you get like this paper by these four pieces? Can you get? See, now the stretch rubber is there. This is original. Can you get the chalk again from this chalk dust? Now tell me the answers. Yes. We get the original rubber by removing the force. We get the chalk. See, after adding some water, okay, mix that. Okay, mix that. Make the roll in a cylindrical form and you can get the chalk. Here also, you can paste this and make a paper, okay? Not in this shape, but you can get the paper. Now we will go towards the physical change based on these three activities, okay? Now what we have learned from this activity? There were some changes, but that changes are physical changes. Now how? That we will discuss. See, I have written here a change in which a substance undergoes a change. In it, physical properties are changing. Now, physical properties, what are the physical properties we have learned? Yes, size, shape, texture, hardness. Okay, many physical properties are there. Now, what is happening here? When I tore the paper, the size of paper is changing. When I make a chalk dust, okay, there is a change in texture, in hardness, in There is also change in shape and size. Means what? If the change is in physical property, so that change is known as physical change. Understood? The first point. Second point I have written here. Normally or generally, the physical changes are reversible. Now, reversible means what? After changing, we get that material or that substance back. Means what? This chalk dust. Okay? From the chalk dust, we can get chalk again. From the stretch rubber, we can get the original rubber. So, like that, many changes are there. From that, we get the material back. I have written here generally, means 99% changes, okay, means the physical changes are reversible. But some physical changes are there that are not reversible, like the paper. Okay, we can stick that paper, but we cannot get that paper as it is. You can see here. After sticking the faux paper, we will get like this. But our original paper is in this shape. Correct? There is a change in physical property. So that change is the physical. But the change is reversible. Understood? The physical changes. And then you have to write 4 examples that you have observed surrounding you. And that changes should be physical change. Okay? Opposite to that, I have written here chemical change. Okay? See, a change in which one or more new substances are formed. Means what? In physical changes, there is no new substance is forming. Means what? After tearing the paper remains paper. Correct? Or after tearing the paper is of metal or iron? No. There is a change, but the material is as it is. Paper is the paper is the. Then the chalk dust. Now if I break that, only the size is changing. Correct? Here is also I have chalk. In this hand also I have chalk. Means after changing, if the new substance is not forming, so that change is known as physical change. Okay? Don't confuse between the physical and chemical. For example, now that stretch rubber. After stretching the rubber, is that rubber is changing into any other material? Or after applying the force, that rubber is changing into plastic? No. After the stretching or removal of that force or the removal of force, the rubber remains rubber as it is. So that change is known as physical change. But opposite to that, chemical change means what? There is a formation of new substance. For example, can you tell me if there is a new substance is forming? For example, that is ripening of fruit. Means what? If raw mango is there. When the raw mango changes to mango. Now what is happening? Shape is as it is. Size is as it is. Only the change is what? Raw mango is changes to mango. Correct? So new substance is forming. And that is known as chemical change. Another example, that is burning of wood. When the wood, we are applying the heat. Okay, wood is there. When we heated up the wood, that wood becomes ash. Means what? Ash is forming from the wood. Correct? So that change is known as chemical change. Understood? Now, with one activity, we will decide that, okay, between or the difference between the physical physical change and chemical change with one example. Okay, so let's start that activity.
See, I have taken the sugar in this bowl. Now, when I started to heat up that sugar for 1 to 2 minutes, you can see here the sugar started to melt. Can you see? You can see here the moisture is there. The sugar started to melt. Now, if I put this amount of sugar in this and make a sugar solution, is the test of this solution can change? Means sugar is in which test? Sugar is in sweet. Correct? If now change is there. The change in what? The change in moisture. Okay, the change in physical property. That sugar started to melt. Means there is a change. But that change is a physical change. Means what? After changes sugar into melted sugar. Only the physical property is changing. Sugar is also sweet and the sugar solution is also sweet. So that is our physical change. Now what is chemical change? Let's see. If we apply more amount of heat to the sugar, see the change. We have to wait for some time to check the difference between the physical and chemical. See the change. The sugar is now changes to black color substance, and that substance is known as carbon. And if I mix this black substance into water, do we get the same solution as our sugar solution? No. Means here, from sugar we get a new substance. Okay, see. Okay, now sugar, we cannot get the sugar back. Means what? Most of the chemical changes are irreversible. Means after changing, we cannot get that material back. Okay, so I hope that you have understand the difference between the physical and chemical change. So in more, let's discuss through the difference.
Okay, now what we have taken for our activity, we have taken sugar. Okay, after applying heat for a small period, that sugar changes to melted sugar. Now, this is which change, physical or chemical? What we have learned in physical? The substance undergoes change. But after change, that identity of that substance remains as it is. Identity means what? The sugar. Here the sugar is in solid form. After heating, that sugar is changes to melted sugar, means semi-solid. Only the state is changing, but the sugar is as it is. The taste of sugar, sweet. Here also the taste of sugar is sweet. Means what? Only the physical properties are changing. And that's why this is physical change. But after applying more heat, this sugar changes to a black substance which is known as carbon. Means what? See the material sugar. Now we get carbon, means new substance is formed because of the change, and that change is known as chemical change. So I hope that you have understand the difference between the physical changes and chemical changes. Now take the screenshot of this difference and write in your notebook 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I hope that you have taken, understood physical change and chemical change. Now today's homework is that you have to write five examples of physical changes and five examples of chemical changes. And one another activity is that you have to write the five changes that are both physical also and chemical also. And then you have to send the pictures of your homework to me with your WhatsApp group. Understood? So here we have completed our first session, in that we have learned the physical and chemical properties, then some types of changes and the difference between the physical and chemical changes. So learn that difference, and in next session we will learn in detail about chemical changes, as chemical changes are important in our life as compared to the physical changes. Okay, so that we will see in our next session. Still, stay home, stay safe, and thank you.